I used to reset the bike to the repels and spit on it.
Bye.
Sydney's parents were glad to see her, but were very upset too.
Joseph, what are you doing with the train?
We were really sick about you.
I don't think trains usually have a backup beep.
What can we do about it? Brainstorming, Sydney started drawing her ideas. After many tries, she sketched one that they both liked. Z proposed. But we'll need
Joseph, what are the animals that you have?
Together, they convinced their neighbors to help.
Can you say goat?
Days,
and what's that one?
Into the wilderness to share Sydney's plan with the other animals.
Giraffe.
Naturally, everyone wasn't used to
operating. Joseph, say giraffe. Are they going to get on the train? Now where are they going to go?
Next morning, Bob, what is that? The dam, inspecting several loose logs nearby, they finally carried one back to the riverbed.
Bob.
Z poked at the wall with her staff. Stick it into this gap, she suggested. Stick it into this gap, she suggested. With the wooden lever firmly in place, one by one they climbed aboard.
What does the train say?
And they popped at the same time, pebbles popped out, and then some rocks. Again and again they jumped, yet they were getting tired, and a few of them were losing hope. "We can't give up now," was the urge. "Come on, one more
Joseph,
time.
What are you doing?
Three, two."
Oh, the book fell down.
Bah, crack. Out bounced a boulder and a fountain spurted into the air. Whoosh. A rush of water broke through the dam, and the animals clambered onto the banks. The river flowed again. Unlikely partners could enjoy their common achievement and a well-deserved rest.
Okay, Joseph.
Hearty congratulations.
I'm going to turn off the camera now. Come here. Come say goodbye to your grandparents.
Bye.
Downstream,